Hey, today I'm going to talk about me and Earl and the dying girl, personal shopper, and Carol. There is no theme with today. There was an attempt at a theme, but it didn't work out, so it's just three good movies. Yep. First up is Me and Earl and the Dying Girl. This is a 2015 movie, and a lot like Frances Ha, this is a movie that I've known about for a long time and had a good feeling that I was gonna like it a lot. And yeah, no, I loved this movie. This, like, from like the first 30 seconds on, I was like, yeah. This movie just vibes so hard with me. I am definitely going to buy the book that this movie is based on. The basic premise is the title. It's about two guys and the relationship with this dying girl. It technically belongs in that subgenre of movies that's about, like, a boy and a girl around teenager age and one of them is dying, and it does a lot of the tropes. But honestly, it has such a good take on them. And it makes them all happen in such a natural way. Like, one of my favorite parts of the movie is towards the end, where, you know, everything kind of gives more drama that happens. People kind of get upset with each other. That's just kind of the way that movies tend to end. And a lot of times it's just kind of something that's contrived. Like, they've been best friends all along, and then it was some stupid misunderstanding. Someone overheard something that they shouldn't have said, and all stuff like that. But in this movie, it does still have the characters who have been getting along this whole time aren't getting along anymore, but it does it in a way that feels so natural. It's more just like there have been rising tensions all along in the background and you could feel it. And this is just finally emotions coming to a head, just a big release of energy. And it felt right for them to be upset because it's very upsetting things that were happening. But it's no one's fault at the same time. It's just so well written, and it's just so great. I of course loved all of the movie references. This movie is just insanely full of references to just, I don't even know, just like the world cinema. Even if you don't get the references, you still feel the charm of the reference in the first place, and it's, this movie is just chock full of charm, and it's all the quirky stuff that I love, and it's just great. And it stars Olivia Cooke, who's just, you know, wonderful and everything, and she shines through here. And I love the main guy, Thomas something. So yeah, I 100,000% recommend this movie. It is delightful and great and so emotional. You might not connect with it as much as I did just because I'm such a nerd, but I still think you're guaranteed in for a good time. I love this movie. It's so good. So good. Our next movie is Personal Shopper. This is a 2015 movie. I recently bought it on Blu-ray. Criterion had a flash sale, and I was like, well, I want to get one movie that I haven't seen before, so this was the movie I went with as like a big risk. And turns out, I actually liked it a lot, so that was a good risk on my part. This is a 2016 French movie, but it's all in English, starring Kristen Stewart. All I'm going to say about the premise is that it's about Kristen Stewart as a personal shopper for this really rich girl who's a big snob and stuff. The movie actually is a different genre of movie than I was expecting, and I kind of think it's a little more fun if you don't know what that genre is or anything else about this movie, just because it's such an interesting story that I was kind of almost blindsided by, but I really, really like this. It is a bit of a quieter movie, so some people might mistake that as a slower movie, but it's really not. It kind of does have a little bit of a slow start, but kind of once it gets going, once you realize what's happening, then you're hooked. It's good. I do want to briefly talk about the end. I'm not going to spoil anything. I was just like, once the movie ended, I really wasn't sure how I felt about it, because it kind of was a different ending than I was expecting. And then I went to the discussion thread like I usually do. And in there, I found some good theories about what that ending meant. And instantly I was just like, yep, this is correct. That ending was great. This movie was great. I really like this movie. That was an interesting ending and an interesting story too. So if you watch this and don't really get what that ending was, like I did, I'd be happy to respond to any messages about this movie because it's good. I like it. I dig it. And Kristen Stewart does a good job. So that's always fun.
And lastly is
Carol, this is a 2015 movie starring Kate Blanchett and Rooney Mara. It's based off a novel from, I think, 1952. This movie technically belongs in a subgenre of films that I didn't know about, which is gay historical movie. Because that's what it is. I've seen a surprising number of gay historical movies. It's just surprising that this is a genre. I wasn't expecting this to be a subgenre of film. It's good though, a lot of them are good. The premise is it's set in the 50s and it's about two women who are all flirty and stuff and maybe they get some emotions towards each other. And yeah, the movie's cute, it's good, it's fine. I wasn't really blown away by it just because I have seen so many other films that are very similar to this. This one just kind of felt a little bit more basic. Rooney Mara was definitely the standout for me. She really carried the movie. Kate Blanchett's technically the title character, but really it's Rooney Mara is the lead of this movie. And also I kind of wish they would have went with a book title. I like that title way more than Carol. So yeah, so I like this movie. It was good. It was fine. It is what it is. If you're a fan of this subgenre film of historical gay movies, it's definitely worth a watch. Alrighty, and now for today's rankings. First up, we got Me and Earl and the Dying Girl. This is sitting at number 2. Look at that. It's my second favorite movie so far this year. It couldn't beat out The Map of Perfect Tiny Things. That movie just, I cried so much at that movie. And I surprisingly didn't cry at Me and Earl and the Dying Girl. I was just like, there's so many sad things happening right now. And I'm just not crying. Normally I would be crying, but I'm not crying right now. I think the next time I watch it, I'm definitely gonna cry. So it'll happen. And then is Personal Shopper, sitting at number 20, also in the really liked category. It's like right at the bottom of really liked, just because it was in the quite liked section until I went to the discussion thread stuff. And then that bumped it up. So it's just, it's good though. It's definitely, it's worth a watch. And then bringing up the rear is Carol in the liked section at number 43. It's kind of almost dead middle of the road for everything. And this is out of a total of 78 movies so far this year.